Nothing personal taken, Miss Bennett.
Would you take care of these admissions for me, please?
If you wish.
Problems?
With the staffing situation as it is, I've enough to do in my capacity as deputy governor.
We'll get Mrs. Jackson to take care of it.
Have you read these?
No, I'll get around to it later.
This woman was here before, caused problems. She's nothing that we can't handle, but Mrs. Jackson may have reservations.
Look, what are we running here, a prison or a kindergarten?
I couldn't agree more.
If Mrs. Jackson has reservations, she can see me about it.
When I finish with these files, I'll put them on your desk.
Fine, I'll get around to them then.
It stinks.
What?
Oh, you know.
That bee?
Yeah, it stinks. And I don't care who hears me say it.
Well, you would if Vera was around.
It stinks. Putting a pound and nobody bothering to prove anything.
Yeah, well, it's all because of Fletch.
Now, that's enough.
Well, it is, Mrs. Jackson. So he lets us off his stupid exercises this morning. Big deal.
Yeah, and what about all the privileges he took off us?
Right, our TV and our radio, even our cards.
Well, if action's to be taken, it's because you've asked for it.
Wouldn't have happened if Mrs. Davidson had been here. You know that, Mrs. Jackson.
Go along, back to work.
I reckon we all ought to front up to him and march into his office.
Oh, we'd never get near it, Lizzie.
Oh, we've got to do something. I've missed three TV specials this week, and on Friday, John Wayne's on.
Why don't we write to the department and complain? Oh,
because, lovey, the screws wouldn't like that. They read all our letters and cut out the bits that they don't like.
They read our mail.
Both ways, in and out.
I thought all that stuff went out years ago.
Oh, screws never change. They've got their own TV sets and that's all they worry about. Even that one.
Don't you say a word against Mrs. Jackson. If they were all like her, we wouldn't be in this mess.
How's it going?
Well, if you can ignore the verbal flack, fine.
I'd soon shut them up.
Well, we haven't all got your special qualities, Vera.
You're to go to reception. A couple of new admissions.
You told me to watch this lot.
Governor's orders. I assume he knows what he's doing.
See that one over there? We call her Vinegar Tits.
What was that, Birdsworth?
Nothing, Miss Bennett. I just said I'm bored to bits.
Are here yet?
Just coming.
Where are the papers?
Over there.
Well, if it isn't dear old Meg Jackson.
Tell him what happened.
It was me. I killed your husband. But you're really glad to see me, eh?
That bastard.
Who?
What's wrong? Jim Fletcher. I've been set up. Here, you'll have to do the admissions. I'm sorry.
Meg, what's wrong? It's nice to know you're welcome.
I want a word with you. In the corridor, if you don't mind.
Governor's orders. Prisoners must be under constant surveillance.
What kind of a twisted joke do you think this is?
What joke?
Did you know that Chrissy Latham was coming back in here?
I pointed it out to the governor. He said we're running a prison, not a kindergarten.
He said what?
He said if you had reservations, you could see him. Look, he's still upset about last night's meeting.
To hell with last night's meeting!
Get back to work, all of you!
He specifically asked for me to admit those prisoners?
Yes.
Me, by name?
Yes, but I'm sure it's nothing malicious. He's just up to his ears in work.
Look, stop trying to defend him, Vera. I am not going to work in this prison while she's here. And I am going to tell him right now.
What's wrong with Mrs. Jackson?
Back to work, Birdsworth.
She looks upset.
It's none of your business.
She ain't in any trouble, is she?
Nothing like that. The one in trouble is someone else entirely.
What the hell do you think you're playing at?
I beg your pardon?
Setting me up like that.
I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about.
Oh, don't give me that.
I'm not giving you anything, Mrs. Jackson, and I want to know why you've come bursting in here like a maniac.
Chris Chrissy Latham.
Who's Chrissy Latham?
Oh, my God. What are you, a half-wit? The new prisoner. Do you know what she did?
I haven't the faintest idea, but I'm sure we can talk about it.
She murdered my husband.
I didn't know. Miss Bennett didn't tell me.
She said you flew at her when she brought it up. Aren't you supposed to be the governor? Didn't you read their files?
Yeah, well, I haven't had time.
Haven't had time? New prisoners. It's your job to make time.
Look, Mrs. Jackson, I'm terribly sorry that this has happened. Now, if you'd care to sit down, I'm sure that we can discuss it.
The only thing I wish to discuss is when you are shipping that woman out, because I am not working while she's here.
Look, Meg, we have...
Mrs. Jackson to you, Mr. Fletcher.
Mrs. Jackson, we have a severe staff shortage. Now, you know that. I can certainly arrange for a minimum of contact,
but... that woman is transferred, I am not working here.
Well, there are procedures. They take time.
Mrs. Davidson would have gone straight to the department. That woman would not have been allowed through the gates. Now, I bailed you out of a hole last night, and I am not doing it again. This time, you can handle the job alone.
Look at her. She's sure pleased about something.
I've admitted the two new prisoners. The doctor's examining them now. Have you seen Meg?
She was here a few moments ago.
Upset? Vera, what's going on? Oh, what's Fletcher up to now?
Look, he's just inexperienced.
Inexperienced? Why is Meg so upset?
Chrissy Latham.
The new girl?
Before you came here, there was a riot. She killed Meg's husband. Look, Mr. Fletcher's under a lot of pressure at the moment.
All right, Vera. I can appreciate your loyalty. Did he assign Meg to admit her?
Look, when he's been in the job longer...
When he's been in the job longer, we won't have a prison. Oh, come on, Vera, that Latham woman should never have been admitted.
I know. What are you going to do about it?
Well, I'm sorry, but last night I thought we'd sorted a few things out. Obviously, we didn't. It's time to do something. You're acting deputy governor. If you want to stand down, we'll understand.
No, I'm a member of the
unit. Oh, good. Right, now I'm going to talk to the others. We'll call a meeting. This time, Mr. Fletcher won't be there.
No sign of head lice?
Told you were wasting your time. Now, do I take my clothes off?
No, Chrissy, you don't.
Oh, you and me, Doc. We'd go really well together.
If you don't mind, I want to check your ears.
My ears? Oh, come on, Doc, I can do better than that.
Chrissy, I've had enough of this.
Well, I haven't done anything yet.
Miss Meadows, take her out of here, please.
But we haven't finished the examination.
We'll resume it later when you're not in such a playful mood.
Oh, well, anyway, plenty of time later, eh, Doc? Oh, Doctor.
Takes all sorts. Sit down, please. You're Pat O'Connell. You a trustee?
I want a parole. I want to be with my kids for Christmas.
How many kids have you got?
Two little ones and the older boy.
I see. What are you in for?
Aiding and abetting. My husband and the oldest boy, they're in an armed hold-up. They came home and I didn't turn them in.
Well, I suppose if that's the law, there are reasons.
Oh, sure, there are reasons for everything. Reasons for that and reasons for what I did.
Well, it shows the kind of man we're dealing with. Allowing that Latham woman back here and then detailing Meg to admit her.
If we don't take a stand, things are going to get worse. Right. Now, I suggest we resurrect all our demands and get the whole thing settled. Now, are you all in agreement?
Yes.
Good.
Sorry I'm late again.
It's all right, Meg. We're all agreed. It's time for drastic action.
Well, that's fine by me.
You feeling okay, Meg?
Sure. Vera not here?
No, but she said whatever we decide, she'll back us up. Why?
It's nothing. Well, what about the others?
Well, they're all in agreement. I've sussed out everyone on duty and those I could get on the phone. It's unanimous.
Okay. Well, what happens next?
Well, I've already been on the phone to the union. They agree it's disgusting, and they're ready to back us to the hilt, anything we decide.
Then I move we strike.
Good. Well, it'll have to work this way. I'll present our demands to Fletcher. If he doesn't accept them, then it's everyone out. All those in favour?
All right.
Against? Carried.
What's going on?
Yeah, it's only the middle of the day.
Oh, come on, Fears. What if we're going to be locked?